a gallery born of an intellectual marriage and a thriving creative partnership. Join me today in my conversation with Shefali, Somani and Anahita, Taneja, the women, the forces behind the beautiful and the extremely noteworthy gallery Shrine Empire. So hi, Anahita and Shefali. It's a real pleasure to have a conversation with the two of you. First of all, tell me something about the kind of response you received at the India Art Fair to your selected artists. And do you think this year was particularly interesting than the last one?
So the India Art Fair this year was really good. It went off very well. The sales were very good. On the whole, the India Art Fair looked really good because there were lesser galleries this time, about 60 galleries who had taken part. And as well as all the booths were bigger sized, and the focus was primarily on contemporary art. So I think honestly, in terms of the contemporary art and South Asia, the focus was there and it really made the fair look really good. And in our booth specifically, we got a lot of interest for Bahram Ijlal's works, who basically had done a 5-year long research on these dilapidated old buildings, where she had gone to intact, taken an entire list from them, and where in 2014 her research actually started. And she then worked on going to these particular sites again and again and taking testimonies from people who lived in and around that building and spoke about, honestly, the history of the land, their personal experiences, their journeys. So each and every recording became a character in that work. And somehow everyone connected with that work, connected with that space, either they had seen it, been, in that area. So I really felt that it brought in a lot of attention towards her practice.
A lot of times whenever we look at an artist's work, either the artist has come recommended to us or we have come across an artist's work in a show, maybe in an article which was written about the artist. So when we started the gallery together, at that time we didn't represent any artist. So we were actually exploring the idea of looking at artists which didn't have any representation with anyone else. And so we started working with these two artists who were sort of diasporic artists. They were based out of New York. One was Samantha Batra Mehta and the second one was Fariba Alam. And as we went, we actually started our gallery by representing diasporic artists. So we represented three diasporic artists. The third one was a video artist called Gautam Kansara. And in fact, our gallery was one of the few galleries which did a full video show for the first time in India with Gautam's work. And it was very, very well received because, it sort of established us as a gallery which is looking at cutting edge practices. We're not afraid to sort of take those risks. We also represent a lot of drawing because I think we both identify with the medium. And so we represent Pooja Puri and Neerja Kothari and also Karan Shrestha, so, and Omar Vaseem. All of their practices have a lot of focus on drawing. Our gallery is also focusing on another area, which is South Asia, and we represent artists, we represent Taiba Begum Lipi from Bangladesh, who is a very well-known artist, and Anoli Pereira from Sri Lanka. And recently we've started representing Omar Vaseem and Karan Shrestha from Pakistan and Kathmandu. Mm-hmm.
So one artist I'm really fascinated by from your roster is Neerja Kothari, and you have an upcoming show like of hers. It's going to be on the 13th of March. So, her personal journey is so riveting. So tell me more about her and her work.
So we represent Neerja Kothari at the gallery, and we've been representing her over 5 years now. But this is her first solo show that we are having in March, on March 13th. So Neerja has been, working for many years now. She, unfortunately, at the age of 20-21, went through a motor sensory neuropathy issue, which she had to go through a physical rehabilitation of that, where she had basically lost, the movements of her body. So she had to retune her brain to re-remember each and every movement again. So simple things like touching her toe, she had to do that again and again to remind her brain of that movement. Once she got better from the physical rehabilitation, she went to the School of Arts at Boston, Tufts University, where she did her BFA and MFA. Post that, she went for a numerous number of residencies, and then she came back and she sort of continued her practice. So all her practice kind of dwells in, you know, trying to quantify the unquantifiable, because she had to actually quantify her movements, which honestly isn't something that people do. You know, trying to get okay, and then even then after that, even though she still sometimes, you know, she has muscle issues whenever she works, you know, works too much. Suppose she's worked, you know, on a particular work for like 4 days nonstop, and she won't be able to work for 1 month because, you know, either her shoulder will give away or her lower back will give away, wrist will give away. Yeah. Team to actually make sure that she is able to produce this entire show.
So Shefali, you've been in the business for 25 years. Now that's a long time. So how has the journey been for you particularly? Has it been a very arduous one, or it kind of just unfolded very organically?
So when I started out, 25 or 24 and a half years ago, it was the gallery business was not so, like, it wasn't such a serious business. It was serious galleries, but a lot of smaller galleries existed. So when I started out with the idea of actually wanting to promote younger artists, you know, because there weren't too many galleries which were very focused on promoting emerging artists. So I started with that intention. And so I worked with either like with emerging artists or with artists whose practice had been ignored. So, you know, there were couple of mid-level artists who I worked with, like Anil Karanje. And then even G.R. Santosh's early works, they were artists who were known, but they had been pretty much, they fell through the cracks. Nobody was representing them. And at that particular time, nobody was actually seriously representing artists. Artists were quite fluidly working with various galleries. But you know, I think the gallery scene completely changed post 2006, you know, 2005, I would say, and everything became a lot more organized. Representation started happening, galleries became a lot more organized. Authenticities, you know, which earlier used to not be so important, in the sense that galleries wouldn't give authenticity certificates for all the artwork. All of those things became very important.
So how did the two of you meet? You know, how did this this kind of intellectual marriage occur? And Anahita, how was your personal journey? I mean, you know, whether it's like before meeting her or even after, this journey of establishing Shrine Empire as a collaborative effort, how did it all happen?
So I started about 14 years back in the arts, but before that I was in media and filmmaking, where I had worked for NDTV and Alipo Films. Post that, after I shifted into Delhi, I started as an art consultant and was doing that for about 3 years, in between which I met Shefali. And we met over like a sale of an artwork, and post that we took it forward by having a show in Kolkata together with a group of artists, and then we took another show in Singapore. And both the shows are very successful, it did really well. And then as two separate entities, we took part at the India Art Fair as Shrine Gallery and Empire Art. And the response was tremendous. We were really, really happy with how it all was sort of unfolding. And we then decided to, you know, partner together, because we felt that why should we do this as two separate entities when we have a similar vision, we want to promote a similar kind of artist. We decided to join hands together and collaborate, and that's how Shrine Empire came into being. Post that, of course, we've been, you know, focused on showing, you know, young talent at the gallery, so that, you know, when you know, somebody kind of comes to Shrine Empire or sort of comes to the gallery, they always sort of find interesting work. After that, you know, to have an interesting dialogue, you know, towards, you know, in fact, on contemporary times. And this is what, I mean, our vision is what we want to focus on and promote even further on. And of course, keep promoting them in India and internationally.
So it was really nice talking to you, and I'm looking forward to the show on the 13th.
Thank you.